Hello, in this video I am going to show you how to use the drop spindle, but it's going to be hanging like that the entire time, not trapped in on your knees. This is a bit harder than the way I showed you in part two. So I suggest you try the park method until you're completely comfortable and then go on to this method. So we've already got our drafted fibre and we have our spinning equipment. So exactly the same as in the last video, have your loop and find the end of your yarn. Here we are. And put it through the loop. Try and make sure it's not too thick where you put it through, because remember it's going to double it up. Through, fan it out, put it over. Give it a quick pull. Okay? So we start off putting it all over our hand with a bit of slack, like that, because you can break it because of the friction pulling over your skin. Show you how to do it. So, unlike the other one, we set it spinning and didn't do anything. In this one, we're going to have to do a lot more with our hands. Now, the basic movement is exactly the same as how I showed you in the first video, where you pinch, pull, and I let go in the last video. In this time, I'm going to pinch, pull, and slide with my thumb and finger. It's a little bit more tricky, so what you might want to give it a go is just getting yourself a bit of a twist. Remember going clockwise. You feel it up on your fingers, and then just giving the pinch and slide a go. So here you are, pinching it, holding it up here, and you're going to slide up to your pinch. Now the reason we want to slide is we're going to have a large lump of fibre here. And you don't want your twist to get into this lump, or you will find it impossible to draft and it'll get all tangled up. So that's why we slide while doing this. So you want to practice that once more. So pinch it, not behind where you last pinched, not in front, exactly the same place. Give it a little bit of a pull. Not too much, just down to the amount you want. For really thin, you would obviously go a lot thinner. For really thick, a lot thicker. Slide up, pinch, let it go. Make sure that looks good. Good little pull. Wind it on. And now I'm going to show you while it's hanging. Now the main difference, while it's hanging, you have no control over the spindle as it's spinning. And the main problem is it can develop over twist here and begin to spin the other way. And once, when I was learning, I made a piece of yarn that each segment I had put onto my bobbin was spun a different direction. I don't know how I managed it, but I did somehow. And plying it was rather difficult. So you'll want to keep going the same direction. So start it spinning and don't wait till you feel it pressing here. Just before you think you're about to feel it, I want you to start that pinch and slide. So I'll show you. I'm going to have to tilt the camera a bit. Okie dokie. Right. Set it spinning, pinch it, slide, and go up. Now you see it stopped there. Always recognise it when it stops because it will immediately start to spin the wrong way again. So it's spinning again, so pull a bit and go up. Right. Let's get myself back in shot. Okay. So it's spinning, go up, slide, pull up. And slide up. So it's spinning again. Go up, slide. Right. Okay. So let me show you a bit better. So up, slide, it's a bit hard to explain with a picture, but that's your basic movement. I suggest you experiment with parking and sliding for a little bit until you go on to it, like I said. Another way you can do it, to just give you a bit of a helping hand, is spin your spindle with it parked on the ground, like that. And so you have it up here, set it spinning on the ground, and that means it won't be pulling on you, because what it will do is yank down here because of the weight of the drop spindle. Even the lightest ones you can buy will do this. So just parking it on the ground there, it still gives you the feeling of it hanging, so you get how to control it, but it just gives a helping hand. Okay, and in my next video I'm going to show you different ways of using different fibres, combining fibres, and different drop spindles and things you can do.